All right, hello, howdy. Welcome to the Earnest Report for Wednesday, February the 1st, out here in Arkansas, where folks are rising up in Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Tennessee against the Diamond Pipeline, also known as the Plains Pipeline. So this is just a quick little review of a proposal that I have in the draft process for some folks in Northwest Arkansas. But I thought I'd explain it a little bit on video, hopefully not take too long, so that lots of folks could see it and I could get some more input. And then of course, yeah, so I basically just wanted to share that. all right, and let's see, so I'll just start. There will be a link in the show notes to the PDF that this draft proposal is on currently, and if enough people in Northwest Arkansas are interested in forming this bus cooperative, then that's great. If the need to extend this proposal outside of Northwest Arkansas arises, then I'll be opening the proposal up to folks. other folks in Northwest Arkansas that are out to stop the Diamond Pipeline, as well as folks in Memphis, Little Rock, and Oklahoma. Ultimately, I'd like this bus to be traveling up and down the pipeline for the various reasons I'm about to outline. So I'm basically just going to run through the proposal. Basically, there are four main purposes for a bus cooperative, one of which is education. So not only will educational material be able to be distributed and stored on the bus as it travels, but the bus itself will be a billboard. Hopefully the outside of the bus could actually be painted with the pipeline route, and it could highlight some of the socially and ecologically sensitive areas. It could raise the overall awareness of the social and ecological dangers of the Diamond Pipeline, and also raise the visibility of the resistance to the fossil fuel development itself. This will help in recruiting across the pipeline, and it'll also help in getting volunteers for other local efforts. And ultimately, it's a billboard that will hopefully spur discussion and help build community relationships in the area. This will lead to increased community engagement. The bus will be involved in public activities. It can bring volunteers to public activities. It can bring resources to public activities. It will, by its nature, be mobile, and we hope to have it connected online so that live and frequent broadcasting can be done from various locations along the pipeline route in Oklahoma, Tennessee, and here in Arkansas. It'll also have the purpose of being a kind of legal watchdog, because of course, it being mobile, it can be on the road and take pictures from public areas of sensitive areas. Also take pictures of, you know, what's happening with the drill, and give live or time-lapse updates of the progress of the at least three drills. There's one currently underneath the Arkansas River, already drilling, it looks like. Also, this bus will be able to, so I'll talk at the end of this, the kind of discussion about a short bus versus a long bus, but a short bus would essentially be able to provide lodging, overnight lodging for three people, a crew of three people, and it would also be able to have volunteers. So it would be able to hold, you know, 6 to 10 people. Da-da-ba-da-ba-ba. This will help show solidarity across the states, and will also hopefully build social resilience in the community as more people become engaged and active. And the bus itself will be an art installation. One of the most beautiful things at Standing Rock was besides the prayers and the ceremonies, was the art and the music. And the bus itself will be hopefully an art installation, slowly built by the people across the pipeline. But also, we hope to have a PA system on it as well as a monitor set up too, so people will be able to watch live broadcasts from the bus and other locations. And it itself will be able to be a kind of loudspeaker at events, which is important. So those are kind of the four main purposes of the bus. The next question is kind of how can this be achieved? And most people would normally start right into like a normal business plan presentation. But since I'm more interested in the cooperative aspect of this, I'm gonna first run through some like membership guidelines of the cooperative, as well as the overall governance structure that actually makes this a cooperative and democratic venture, as opposed to the kind of capitalist ventures that we're used to in society. But basically, the membership would consist of members with a voting share. You'd also have a volunteer council of members to kind of take care of the administrative roles. I refer to these as the facilitator, the secretary, and the steward. Many of you that are familiar with like president, vice president, secretary, treasurer, these are just kind of a different way of viewing those roles. Each membership is worth one vote, and a membership can be done by an individual, or it can be done by a group of individuals that want to purchase a share collectively. And I can assist with that process. And basically, using a circle forward governance method, a group of folks can stay very informed and active and make decisions, even if they're much larger than the actual bus cooperative itself. Members, of course, should act in good faith and cooperative spirit, really don't, and should attend most meetings. The Uber Conference app is a very easy one to do phone meetings and stuff like that. So I don't foresee it being a problem being able to communicate as a bus cooperative, even if the ownership of the cooperative is spread out across the three states. Many folks are familiar with the Robert Rules of Order and making proposals. And so in this cooperative, any member can actually make a request for assistance or an offer of assistance. So we encourage both. And some of the details can, of course, be changed by the members of the cooperative that eventually develop. But I think at least 80% of the membership consensus, with no strong objections, can actually be used to move forward on requests or offers. So this is a very simple, very fluid cooperative with a easy or simple membership structure, not wanting to make this difficult or too large. And for the governance structure, basically the Robert Rules of Order, the Rules of General Assembly, and Circle Forward Governance are all to be used as a guide for kind of moving through the governance of the organization of the cooperative. The membership structure essentially has three volunteer unpaid roles. So you have a facilitator that writes and hosts meetings and follows an agenda. You have a steward who's able to handle budgetary reporting and tracking, and this will actually, I recommend making it public through publicly accessible Google Docs, so that anybody that has a financial interest in this cooperative or decides to donate to the financial cooperative to help with the expenses or renovations can actually see where their money's going and have complete public access to that as it happens online. So transparency there, pretty straightforward. Secretary is basically maintains the patterns and details, and so kind of records them, and also makes sure that people are familiar with previous meetings and stuff like that through recording the agendas and sharing them. Kind of details that can be figured out. The membership itself will be its own membership council. And essentially, its function is to make decisions on scheduling, maintenance, and finances, what relationships folks that are using the bus, what relationships need to be built or could be built stronger through using the bus. And of course, again, this is kind of the small bus versus large bus, but making sure that the bus always has a place to park. And then figuring out exactly how to do the ownership of the bus are kind of details that can be, that'll be under the purvey of the membership council. And then, of course, I'm volunteering to drive the bus and help maintain it and help organize people and keep track of the organization of people through through using the bus and through various broadcasts. Perhaps such as this one. And there will be a cap on membership with 9 members shares. And the way I have the finances figured out, which I'll go into here shortly, we really only need 5 membership commitments in order to get started. And bam. So pretty easy to accomplish, pretty straightforward kind of cooperative principles to help govern and kind of guide the organization. Now for the finances. So basically I'm looking for a short bus or long bus that already has the seats removed, that is somewhere around $2,500. I estimate that with a cost of a bus that's $2,000, the RV insurance is going to be less than $500, the remodel will be between $300 and $600, and another $1,000 for a 3 to 6 month travel budget. Brings the total costs for the bus about $4,000 or $4,500, depending on the cost of the bus. And basically, the cost of one share, if we're looking for 9 shares, the cost of one share is going to be $500. And this can be covered by an individual or group of individuals. And essentially, after 5 to 9 shares is committed to, and a bus is found, and a mechanical assessment on a bus is figured out, then we can move into purchasing a bus and then complete the selling of shares or fundraising in order to get the budget and the remodel. And I already have folks that are, I don't foresee remodeling the bus being very much of an issue. I kind of have faith in the artistic expression of folks out here, that will get done. I also have the resources to get a very good mechanical assessment once a bus is found. And I'm currently trying to get a hold of 1 or 2 bus owners via Craigslist. Hoping to get contact with one by tomorrow, so that tomorrow I can go check out a short bus in Fort Smith. But it looks like I'm going to start looking at some long buses too, because we're still kind of weighing the pros and cons of that. The larger the bus, the closer it has to stay to I-40 and the pipeline route. Of course, a short bus can actually fit in one single parking space and would be easier to get out in some of the places out here, for sure. All you have to do is drive around, get off a highway road, get onto a county road, and you'll see the kind of difference that a short bus and long bus might have. And then, of course, in the PDF that I have, it kind of goes into a little bit of the more specifics on some of the financing, how to repay back folks for their share if they decide to get out, stuff like that. But the main thing is, so that's the basic gist of the bus cooperative. It's still in its draft stages. I am looking for interested folks that want to help make something like this happen. I am actively looking at buses and accepting donations of buses or a lease of a bus. Must include an exterior paint job. And I am also currently meeting with media folks in order to get broadcasting done in a professional manner that's low cost, can start out in small stages, probably start out with these boring videos. But I have media in the works to kind of support the stuff that's going on out here. Again, since you can see some of the stuff that Bold Oklahoma is doing, media is becoming very important out here. And so ultimately at this point, I'm looking for as much input as possible, wanting to find out what kind of support is out there, who'd like to travel in the bus and take pictures of the pipeline, regardless of who the owners end up being. This bus will be hopefully just driving up and down the pipeline. Yes. I actually want a bus for each drill, but we'll start with one bus. We can watch a couple drills and see what kind of help that does for the movement out here. So, thank you for your time. Have a good day. Thanks for rising up in Arkansas. Thanks for rising up in Oklahoma. Thanks for rising up in Tennessee. And thanks for getting involved in your community, wherever that's at. And thanks for standing up with Standing Rock. We are everywhere.